On one occasion, the nun Suba was going to the delightful Jivaka mango garden. Then suddenly, a rogue appeared and stood blocking her way. Suba said to him, "What wrong have I done to you that you should stand there blocking my way? It is not fitting, sir, that a man should touch a nun. I deeply respect the Buddha's path. The Sublime One has taught us about the precepts. I protect those precepts purely. I am taintless. So why are you standing here, blocking me?" "No, you wish to go by the wrong path. You seek to have the moon as a toy. You wish to jump over the Mount Meru. Understand me. The one you wish for is a daughter of the Buddha. In this world, with its gods, nothing can arouse lust in me. I don't know what lust is anymore. By following the path of Nibbana, I have rooted out lust. Like sparks from a pit of burning coals cooling down, like destroying a bowl of poison, I destroyed lust. By following the path of Nibbana, I have rooted out lust. You may seduce a woman who is not insightful or who hasn't seen the Buddha through the Dhamma, but not me. You bother me, as I have realized the true nature of life. Whether I am insulted or praised, in both happiness and unhappiness, my mindfulness is well established. I have understood that all conditioned things are disgusting. My mind does not cling to anything at all. I am a disciple of the Buddha. I travel in the vehicle called the Noble Eightfold Path. I have pulled out the dart of lust and destroyed the taints. My heart only delights in an empty hut. I have seen well-painted wooden puppets fastened by strings and sticks. They dance in various ways. If these strings and sticks are removed, thrown away, scattered, and broken into pieces, then there is no puppet in them whatsoever. In which part of them should one delight? This body is also like a puppet. It does not exist with supporting factors. As it does not exist with supporting factors, in which part of the body should one delight? Just as you see a picture painted on a wall of a woman, colored with paint, if people mistake it for a real woman, it is because their perception is disordered. You are blind. You run after an empty thing, which is like an illusion placed before you by a magician. You are often a gold tree someone had in a dream. You are like playing in a puppet shown in the midst of people. These eyes are like balls set in hollow groves, with a bubble in the middle, smeared with tears. Inside these groves, there are eye secretions, various sorts of tendons, and flesh rolled into balls. The good-looking lady, Suba, was not attached to her eyes. With an unattached mind, Suba suddenly tore out one of her eyes. She said, "Come take this eye for yourself," and straight away she gave it to the man. These verses were said by Arahant Nun Suba, who dwelled in the Jivaka Mango Grove.